Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and today's video is more of an experiment than an actual tutorial, because we'll explore a way with which we can possibly cut our render times by a huge amount. And for this we're going to use an app called Dane App. It allows us to interpolate between frames, so that we only have to render, say, every fourth frame. This has been tested on stop motion and real life footage, but today I wanted to take it a step further and see how good it performs on smoke simulations. And if the AI can guess at the smoke behavior correctly. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing, because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get started. Of course, we will first have to set up a simulation, and for this I'm using Houdini. In older videos, I've already showed you how to do this, but I will quickly go over the process of what I did for this video. For the emitter object, I added in a torus, so control click on this icon right here, so a torus is being created in the center of the world. The torus object now appears in this tab, and we can double click it to enter it, and adjust the inner and outer radius. By holding down the middle mouse button and dragging, we can easily adjust these values, just like this. And now that we have a base emitter, you can either choose to animate it, or directly go over to the Pyro of X tab, and choose Flames. You can now see that Houdini tells us to select the object to burn, so let's select the torus and hit enter. And after some calculation you can see that everything has been set up for us. Now to take a look at our simulation, let's enable this real-time button right here and click on play. And you can see that this is just a basic fire and smoke simulation. The reason why I'm doing this in Houdini is because it bakes a lot faster and looks a lot better than in Blender. Now there are some problems I quickly want to fix, and this is to go into the Autodop network and select the resize container. And right here under max bounds, uncheck clamp to maximum, and now the domain moves with our simulation. You could choose to add in some forces, and so this is what I'm gonna do now. So click tab and search for gas vortex confinement. This is the force I will use today. And just plug it in right here, and it will take effect on our simulation. To export the simulation, we'll have to go into the Pyro import object and export it from this node. We'll do this by firstly adding in a convert VDB node. And let's click on this little arrow right here. Choose density, fuel, heat and temperature. These will be the attributes we will use in Blender to shade our simulation. And choose VDB. And now just add in a file cache node. Connect it. And to correctly save our VDB sequence, let's click on this icon and, for example, name it pyro underscore cache. And now we'll have to add $f4. This will give every file for every frame another name, just so we actually get a sequence exported. And now end it with .vdb and click on accept. To now bake the simulation, you will have to just click on save to disk. Before this, I would suggest you to again enter the Autodop network and select this pyro smoke object and adjust the division size to your liking. For example, to 0.02. This will give you some good detail in your simulation. Now over in Blender, we can create a new scene and delete everything. And now select the import OpenVDB option right here. Locate your VDB sequence, select everything with A and click on import. Now if I play, you can see that everything works correctly. This sequence has 95 frames, so I will set the endpoint right now. And now we can start shading our simulation. So let's give our volume object a new material. Let's also quickly add in an HDRI, just so we have some light. I would suggest you to directly save your file, because Blender tends to crash often with smoke simulations. Okay, now we have a lot of different options to shade our simulation. We can either just up the blackbody intensity slider, but this doesn't look that great. So let's add in an attribute node and let's try the other two attributes we exported, which were heat and flames. And we can now plug the factor into the emission strength input. Heat looks right off the bat pretty good and flames doesn't. So let's use heat and a simple blackbody node for the emission color. We can up the temperature to get a color we like and also adjust the density to a point where you think it looks good. And now we can set up the camera to render out our simulation. I will do this vertically because this fits the simulation better. Now one thing we can change is the volume light bounces. Bringing this value up will have an effect on your render times, because they will be much slower. But with the method we'll explore today, this might not be an issue for you. One thing I have to address is the fact that you'll need a lot of VRAM for Dane app to work. I personally just exported the sequence in 25% of the initial resolution, but this might be different for you. And now to only render every fourth frame, you can adjust the frame step value and set it to 4. This will now skip 4 frames ahead when rendering. So you'll render frame 1, frame 5, frame 9, and so on. You can see right here that I've rendered every fourth frame, and it really shows because the simulation does pretty big steps between frames. And now we have to somehow interpolate the missing frames with Dane app. You can get Dane app for free on their Patreon. You can just download it right here. You don't have to subscribe, this is a public post. But the link will also be in the video description. Once downloaded and extracted, you will have to enter the Dane app alpha folder and select the daneapp.exe file and run it. Now you can see that we can either choose to input a video or a PNG sequence, and because I have rendered it as a PNG sequence, I will select this option. And now we have to select an input folder path and an output folder path. After you've done this, you'll have to go into the interpolation options tab and set a input FPS value. I know that this simulation looks good in 24 frames per second, so I want to have 24 as my output frames per second. Because I'll interpolate times 4, the input frames have to be 6. And now you can either click on perform all steps or choose to manually perform each step individually. If you should run out of VRAM, Dane app can automatically downscale your video. Just enable the downscale video checkbox and input a new height. And after everything is done, you should be left with a output folder that looks like this. And in the interpolated frames folder, you will see all the frames of your simulation. Dane app should also work with an alpha channel. So if you exported your simulation with a transparent background, you can now, for example, use it as assets in videos or 3D scenes. I personally found that only rendering every fourth frame still looks pretty convincing, and not like the method where we only render every eighth frame, which is of course faster, but it really starts to look janky. That's basically it. This is how we could possibly cut our render times, and if you found this tutorial helpful, consider liking and subscribing, and we'll see you in the next video, next Saturday.